That part is without geotextile, which is having all type of dirt, things and etc. And geotextile bank, which every the growth of grass and other things is also properly done. Natural fibers and synthetic fibers are generally selected for this purpose. Natural fibers, they are biodegradable, and so their selection is done in the situation where biodegradability is necessary. Rami is the best fiber. Rami belongs to the category of bast fiber, just like jute, and it is the best fiber in as functioning as a geotextile. Jute, due to its biodegradability, it is its application is in erosion control, separation, filtering, drainage, in civil engineering works and agriculture uses. And in West Bengal and other parts, they are mainly using jute and other materials, related materials. Coir, the outer surface of coconut, that is also used in many, the many types of nets are prepared, or a coir log is prepared, and that coir log or nets, they are put in the, on the surface of water, on the slopes, so as to prevent the flow of the water. Synthetic fibers, a long list is there, and even after this also number of other developments have taken place in the synthetic fibers. The first one was polyethylene, which was manufactured in 1931. And apart from that, polyester, polyamide, polyethylene, polypropylene, PVC, polyvinyl chloride, PCB, ethylene, polymer bitumen, and chlorinated polyethylene, they are also used. I will not go into detail of this because these materials will require explanation by in length. Then, how geotextiles are selected? In what form? They may be knitted, woven, non-woven, composite, and number of other forms they can be prepared. They can chemically bonded, thermally bonded, mechanically bonded, or they may be in the form of staple fibers. Number of varieties are there, and all these varieties can be selected depending upon our requirement. What is our requirement? This is how we can manufacture different types of geotextiles. Woven textiles. But just like a woven fabric, these textiles are there, and they are selected according to use for separation and filtration purpose. This is the view of the woven geotextile. Natural materials which we can use as geotextile, as I told you, that it's jute, rami, coir, etc. They have got many advantages, like highly water absorbent, high tensile strength. They can handle very high water velocities, they are biodegradable, and they are cost effective, they are very cheap. Synthetic materials can also be used. The advantage of synthetic materials, they are very strong, and they impart more strength compared to the natural materials. These are some of the views of woven monofilaments, woven structures, monofilaments, then multifilaments and slit tip, etc. Non-woven, we are preparing a sheet, we are placing the fiber together, and a non-woven thing is prepared, nothing, no weaving is done in this case. These are some of the examples of non-woven materials. Knitted, just like knitting of sweaters and other things, here knitted type of geotextiles are prepared. Apart from all these three, that is woven, non-woven and knitted, we are also having geocell, geofoam, geocomposite, geonet, geogrid, and geomembrane. These are different forms of synthetic fibers, synthetic materials which can be used as geotextiles. How we can install them? First of all, the surface of the soil, that is earth, is made very smooth. If any stone is there, then those stone has to be removed, because on that surface we have to layer the fabric. The fabric should be without any crease, and then gravels are put on the surface of the fabric, and then with the help of a dozer, we are giving a uniform layer to the gravels. Geotextile, how it is used for roadworks. This is some other examples of roadworks for separation, filtration, reinforcement and protection. For railway track also, some years ago, they were using only stones, but nowadays geotextiles are used between the railway tracks. Then on coastal areas and river canals, we are using geotextiles. Even in Narmada canal, which we have installed from Namda to Bhuj and Kutch, the geotextiles have been used. And this is the eighth wonder of the world. In Dubai, there are two islands. The islands are shown over 1 and 2. And these islands are prepared with the help of textiles and civil engineering people. In sport field construction, playing fields, astroturf, etc., they are prepared with the artificial turfs, they are prepared with the help of geotextiles. Then in trench drains also we can use geotextile, that is jute is used over here. See, one thing is very clear that whenever we are using, whenever we are selecting any particular type of geotextile, if it is natural, it is not a problem for soil and earth. But if it is a synthetic type of geotextile, then it may cause harm to the environment, to the living organisms which are living inside the earth's surface. So fish, animals, microorganisms, etc. should not be affected whenever you are doing any selection of any particular type of geotextile. And third generation textile, the third field which I have selected is the protective field. And in that case, I have selected textile plus mechanical textile. I am not going to other fields because chemical and other biological fields also can be selected for preparing this type of protective textiles. But I have limited myself to the preparation of protective textiles based on mechanical engineering, that is bulletproof or ballistic textiles. The primary areas of protection under this is ballistic, which I am taking today. Chemical and biological can also be there. Detection through odor, noise and visual, flame and thermal may be there. And insect and microorganism types of protective textiles are also available. Anti-ballistic textiles are widely used for defense purpose in police, firefighting, in airspace, etc. These were the earlier type of bulletproof or protecting our body, which the warriors or the persons who were involved in wars, they used to wear, but they were very, very heavy. It was very difficult to, comfort was not there, because they wearing the pieces made up of iron and other metals, it was very difficult for the warrior persons. Nowadays, we are having, with the help of synthetic fibers and other materials, the comfort factor is provided to the wearer. This is how the mechanism takes place. The bullet is coming from a far distance. It comes to the fabric. It just, the impact gets spreaded up and either the fabric gets worn out, but the body is protected. This is how the impact is taking place, and they are the visuals of some impact which has taken place on the fabric. Remember again, only the fabric will be damaged, no harm will be caused to the wearer. These are some of the factors which influence the absorption capacity of ballistic protective systems. Number of things are to be taken into account. All these things have to be considered while designing a particular fabric for bulletproof textiles. There is a gas chamber. A projectile or a bullet is shot from at a distance, and the fabric is hanged between the clamping ring, and this type of damage can take place. So we have to take into account of the sharpness of the bullet. If it is a hemispheric, then it may spread. If it is a flat, again spreading will take place. If it is conical, then it will slip up. It should be light in weight, bulk should be more, it should be comfortable to the wearer, and body movement should be easily facilitated. Again, these things I have already discussed. A nylon is there which can be used, but nowadays nylon is not much used for bulletproof wearing purposes. It is used for other applications. These are bulletproof bags which are more available in the market. Then bulletproof jacket is there. Bulletproof durable tool belts is there. Helmet, watches and bulletproof shoes are available. Carbon fiber is used for preparation of seats, armchairs at airports and other places, and this is bulletproof watch. Bulletproof cycle is there. It is made up of carbon and other materials. This is a sports shoes made by Michael Jordan, a football player, and it is having combination of nylon and carbon fiber and other materials, and this is a bulletproof shoes. Ceramic materials, ceramic fibers are used. Aramid fibers, which is aromatic nylons, they are widely used because of their high strength and other advantages. Kevlar is the best known aramid available. Para-aramid fibers are also used. Glass fiber is used for protection of windows and other things in case of cars and aeroplane sheets. Ultra-high modulus polyethylene is used for bulletproof textiles. Thermoplastic liquid crystal polymer is used. These are some of the organic materials, advanced organic materials, which are now widely available in the market. How the testing is done? The testing has to be done not on a person, but a tank is prepared from bulletproof material and a bomb or some bullet is shot at it, and the result and the impact is seen on the fabric. It can be woven, non-woven, and composite or laminate, just as I've discussed in geotextile. Similarly, here also three categories are there. I'll not go into detail because of the time constraint. These are the bulletproof jacket and the helmet from such materials. This is a bulletproof pocket square. Inside the pocket, there is a handkerchief. This handkerchief is having seven layers, and this handkerchief alone is made up of a bulletproof material. So it is placed over here, and if the shot comes over here, it will protect your heart. How the person who is dealing with the explosive material, bomb or something like that, his whole body is covered with a bulletproof material from top to bottom, and in this doll there are chances that there may be a bomb. So he's dealing with the bomb, and his body is protected, so he will not be damaged. And now the last part, that is herbal textiles, that is textiles related with our ancient old Ayurvedic science, botany, pharmacy, and medical science. There are two processes associated with Ayurvas. Then the fabric is first medicated before weaving, and the fabric is medicated after weaving, and then it is dyed. There are various stages. First is resizing. We have to remove the size.